What's happening, Polite Society? I hope you're having a good week. Today, I'm going to be providing an update on the continual stand Pastor John MacArthur and Grace Community Church have been making against the County of Los Angeles. So let's delve in. Hello, everyone. If you're here for the first time, welcome to my channel. I'm Alan. On Thursday, September 24th, a California judge sided with John MacArthur and Grace Church over GCC's decision to hold indoor worship services. In the ruling, LA County Superior Court Judge Mitchell Beckloff stated that Pastor John and Grace are entitled to a full trial on the merits of their challenge. For months now, Los Angeles County has attempted to shut down Grace Church and to hold Dr. MacArthur in contempt of court. Attorneys have argued that Newsom's orders violate several aspects of the California state constitution. Judge Mitchell ruled that the courts must first decide whether the shutdown orders are constitutional before they can pursue contempt charges against Pastor MacArthur. Due to the state's own inane lockdown orders, the trial for contempt is not expected to take place until 2021. A hearing on November 13th is scheduled, in which the court will examine the scope of GCC's challenge. Last month, the county told Grace Church that it would terminate a lease for a parking lot, which the congregation has been using for 45 years. Pastor John also indicated that he received a letter threatening the Bible teacher with up to 6 months in jail if Grace continues to hold indoor worship services.
Did Gavin Newsom threaten to do anything to you personally for defying, essentially, his order?
No, not personally, but we received a letter with a threat that we could be fined or I could go to jail for a maximum of 6 months. Of course, you know, my biblical hero, apart from the Lord Jesus Christ, is the Apostle Paul. And when he went into a town, he didn't ask what the hotel was like. He asked what the jail was like because he knew that's where he was going to spend his time. So I don't mind being a little apostolic. If they want to tuck me into jail, I'm open for a jail ministry. I've done a lot of other ministries and haven't had the opportunity to do that one. So bring it on.
It's interesting that Pastor John pointed out that a neighboring synagogue has graciously offered to provide their parking lot to Grace members if they need it. But not only that, the judge also stated that the county is prohibited from denying Grace members access to the parking lot which the church leased from LA County until the case is heard. So double blessings on that one. As I've pointed out before, even if someone wears a mask, they still have an over 97% chance of becoming infected with C-19. So the counter argument is, well, the masks protect you from the larger particles that come from sneezes and coughs. But what does that mean? If a person is violently sneezing or coughing, then that means that they're symptomatic. So if I don't have symptoms and I'm still carrying C-19, the particles are still going to penetrate through your mask, right? So why do I need to wear a mask if I'm asymptomatic and I'm carrying the virus, since the small particles are still going to penetrate through your mask? Again, when people are in panic mode, there is little logic and critical thinking taking place. Another argument that they like to use is, well, the Bible says that we are to love our neighbors. Okay, well, I want to love as many of my neighbors as I possibly can. I want to make that net as wide as I possibly can. Polaris is a group which operates the National Human Trafficking Hotline. In a recent study done by them, they found that crisis trafficking situations have risen by 40% in April 2020, compared with the numbers from April 2019. This shutdown has put millions of Americans and millions of others across the world out of work. It is leading to the starvation of many, many people across the globe. In Australia, police choked a woman, then held her up against a wall and started leaning on her because she wasn't wearing a mask, even though she had a doctor's note which excused her from wearing a mask. There was a pregnant woman who went for a walk and she got tired, so she sat down on a park bench and police started harassing her because she wasn't wearing a mask. Thankfully, someone was filming it on their phone and the cops backed down. This is not loving our neighbors. This is hating our neighbors. This is totalitarian rule at its heavy-handed worst. The third argument you'll hear is, well, what about Romans 13 and 1 Peter 2? We are to be subject to the governing authorities. Well, yes, in certain contexts we are, but why? Because they are supposed to punish evildoers and reward those who do good. There is nearly unanimous and universal consensus among the left on this shutdown. And I know a lot of conservative governors have capitulated too, but here's the thing. At least among conservatives, there's room for debate on this subject. On the left, there's pretty much just one voice. Shut down the economy, wear masks, social distance. Don't ask questions, just do it. This is a party that supports and endorses the murder of children in the womb. They support the profaning of marriage and the destruction of God-created male-female gender identity. The governments in leftist states are not the government that the two apostles are talking about in Romans 13 and 1 Peter 2. Well, people will say, well, the Roman government was bad too. Yes, that's why when some pagans left infant children to die from exposure on the streets, Christians would take those children and adopt them as their own. This is why when people were asked just to burn a little incense to Caesar, Christians would say, nope, not going to do that. Jesus is Lord, not Caesar. Well, today's governments aren't saying that you can't worship. Yes, they are. To Grace Church, they are. Well, you can still worship outdoors if you wear a mask. Not if you live in Death Valley or some places in Arizona. You will fry. And again, I know and recognize that the church is split on this issue. But let me tell you something, guys. The greatest enemy of socialism always has been and always will be authentic Christianity. And leftists are socialists. They're not liberals. They are socialists. And these power-hungry leftist governors and mayors will not simply cease with their iron fist of control at C-19. They will continue to go after the church. There is no doubt about that. So once again, be in prayer for Pastor John, Grace Church, and not only them, but all of the small and local churches out there who have taken a stand on this issue. So we are living in dark times, but just remember that Christ is on his throne and he will continue to build his kingdom. And the gates of Hades will not prevail against him. Ladies and gents, if you want to share your own thoughts, be sure to do so in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, guys. If you liked that video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like the content here, you can subscribe by clicking on the icon on the bottom right. Then you can hit the bell for notifications. I upload a new video every Wednesday and every Saturday. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram. I've posted links below. Have an awesome rest of your week. And for my brothers and sisters in the Lord, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all always. I will see you all in the next video. God's blessings on your week.